Okay, ladies and gentlemen, today we are here on a Sunday. We got the brand new 50-ton rotator for Plaza Towing. What we're gonna be doing here is we're gonna do a practice lift on this red Freightliner that you recognize in an old episode. What we're gonna go ahead and do is just do a practice lift. First pick with the new rotator. Did on that side. You pull that out just a touch more. Just a touch.
Okay.
Yep, just a little. Right there. That's fine. Huh? So, Dad, general rule of thumb. Where you at? I said, general rule of thumb, if we can set up a full platform, we should. A general rule of thumb. If we can set up a full platform, we should. Since we're working off the side, we'd really only have to do that side, but since we have the room, we should do it. Say again? No. Should. We need to stock it with a lot of wood. Right here, we're all right, because it's asphalt, but if we were in like a mud stuff, yeah. Yeah.
The good thing is that front box.
Yeah.
You got that side out?
All the way out, yep. So lift the front end up off the ground. Or not yet. Just get some weight off of it first. Discrepancy over that. Sean's dad says no, Sean says yes. I mean, no, other way around.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. All right, both of these down at the same time. That's your H beam. So, that one, yeah, there you go. But both of them at the same time. You have to move, yeah. There you go. Your H beam now.
Yeah.
pretty much dead level this way. We need to come forward on our rears. So we'll go. So we're dead level this way. We needed the rears to come up just a touch. What's that? So look at your levels. Pretty much level. So I it was like down 2 degrees, so I brought it up. So look level to you. All right, house lock. We gotta make sure we do that. We should do that before we do anything. We should cycle those just in case they, you know what I mean? I'd keep it down, Dad, because we're gonna have to unhook those.
But I just need it.
Huh? Yeah. I'll probably post it like after the truck's lettered and everything. That way the first video isn't the truck not lettered. So they stayed free, correct? Cool.
Oh, we don't want that.
I know, right? Probably the easiest way, Dad, would be boom over the hood there. Get your cables in and then we can set it.
I just didn't want it to swing back into the truck.
Big chain bridle up here, and that'll free up a whole bucket in that chain carousel. Get to work. I can't lift anything.
Easier.
Dad, another good habit. You can't move that, a good amount of weight's on there. That's a good test. You know what I mean? Like, if you could spin that thin, that means there's no weight on there. That's not good.
We've got a lot of frame.
really short along the frame over there.
Right.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. It's gonna center itself.
All right, so shorten it up on each end then.
You have a lot of slack over there.
Alright, so keep it free and boom over this way. Those frame chains. When we pick it, it's gonna center itself and then we'll be alright. What it says right now, Dad? 45,000 out of three part?
Four part. We're at 16,000 on a single lot.
33
right.
Is two.
So I mean, that's about what this truck actually minus the axle.
You're probably 14,000 right in there.
I'm guessing.
So we should be on two part though.
Huh?
We should be on two part.
Well, see, that's the way I did.
Because one line's good for 16,000.
Yeah.
So, do the math on that, we're more than reason.
You're dividing there 16 on each, so.
Right, given that you do it in even load. What's that? Yeah, not at short, but it just even. Even's the big thing. Actually, make this side a tad bit shorter so it levels it out, because this is slacking a little bit.
Yeah,
that's what that chain. on slightly shorter.
The frame change?
Yeah, frame change right into the frame here behind the fifth wheel plate. With white fingers. All right. Hang on, Dad. Come down just a touch. You gotta be wary of these pinch points here. So that's a good spot for that. There you go. That's like a bolt cutter on those chains. Take it completely off the ground, that back end's gonna swing into the truck, right? Yeah. So you wanna kinda just work it over so you're right off the side.
How far would that extend out?
Oh, it'll go out there 30 something feet. You got 3,000 pounds. Right here, you're passing. Yep. So I'd pick up with your rear and just kind of scoot it over this way, you know? As soon as you get this thing all the way up, it's gonna wanna center with the boom and swing in your truck. It's 7,000 now. Said at that point right before you picked right now, you only have 3,000 pounds, so obviously, sure. Yeah, it's dropping.
It's getting back to center.
Right,
it's
getting back. No, what I'm saying is you had 3,000 pounds on the boom.
Yeah.
So your front end was dropping and you lost a bit. There's 13,000.
Not very center.
blue. And we'll shorten up the other side.
We gotta shorten up the...
Shorten up the spar side. Give me a little bit more. She's up. We have 14, just under 15.
15,000?
Just under 15,000. We got 14,500. I'm gonna take a look at the other side. See what it's doing. Alright, so a good test. We do have a good amount of weight there, even though the pick is off the side. You're good. See what I meant though? How it centered itself to wherever your boom is. Huh? Well, what I was telling my dad right now is that that truck is gonna go wherever the boom is. So since we're a few degrees off the side, it's gonna center itself to that. Right. That's something we gotta be conscious of. I also want to be conscious of
boom up a little bit.
Right, that's what I was gonna say. You probably want to boom up from here because you want to be conscious of that angle there. You could even boom out. I mean, if you look at our charts here, we're at 30, right?
Well, I'm going up now. I'm at 33 degrees. So.
Right, so I mean, we're good for 20,000 pounds full extension at 30 degrees.
I guess I want to be cooled up when I'm moving away from
you. Right. I'd cable down, Dad. Because as you're booming out, you're still bringing it up to you.
So that 34 angle, that 15,000 pounds.
Hit the axle there. Getting there, homie. Getting there.
Just leave it hooked up for tomorrow.
There you go. You're clear, Dad. Swingy, swingy. Thank you. rotate it back around?
Yeah.
All right. Did you turn it off? Not yet. I'm gonna get it closer to the ground, then I'm gonna level. I'm booming in.
Huh?
I'm booming in right now. Now I'm cabling in and booming in. Keeping it level. Another thing, you know, we were so worried about it going around the corner. In this case, if something were to,
yeah, but low.
Yeah, so that
yeah,
would
hit.
Dragging a little bit. Chart here, we're at 60% capacity, boom angle 33. We can pick 28,000 pounds in this configuration, and but the load that we have on 16,000, so well within reason. Truck here. That's still got a decent amount of weight on it. boom up, table down. Keep it nice and level. Booming up is going to increase our capacity, make the truck stronger. That's crazy how much room we have there. Yeah. I'm booming up too, like we're bringing it closer to us.
Yeah, but the other 1,000 pounds from the front axle isn't going to matter.
Not really.
I wonder if we can put a limb on like here, put this guardrail.
Oh.
Just go right over the guardrail.
That's what I think you could. It'd just be good practice to do
so. So the guys don't have to get that close to it. Like that's
right. I understand what my dad was doing. He was worried about first pick and everything. But this truck's, I mean, all the way around, it can do pretty a tractor full extension.
Even with the weight on that side, this outrigger is digging into the pavement.
Yeah, that's why I keep going over there, just making sure that we have good. See, I'm booming out, cabling down, keeping it level to the ground. Not super high up off the ground, because every time you boom out, cable comes up.
Well, you don't need to keep it that high off the ground, though.
Right, that's why I like to keep it as low as I can.
Because right now, we've already got it out of the ditch, or wherever it was.
Right. Now what I can do is come down with blue.
Boom!
Down in North Shore.
Oh, let's just pick that thing up with a rotator. Booming all the way out now. Charts, making sure we're within reason here. Pick it up. I keep waiting for the boom to bottom out and it keeps going. Now we're all the way out there. Okay. Good there? I need a picture. You want my phone? Huh? I love this remote. It's very manageable. Huh? Get it closer to us. Right there good? Huh? Good here? Spinning, you see that? The hook over here is it. Hooks are tough. That's cool. That's really cool. Okay. Here, you want these? faster than white?
Looks like it is.
I think it's because I'm booming in. Yeah, booming in must take away a little bit of hydraulic function.
Did they purposely make a blue one and a white one so you can see which line you're on?
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's like it's all coordinated here. Because when you're off to the, when you're rotating stuff, like, there's no way you'd be able to be like, oh, left winch, right winch. I think all trucks should have this. My truck, my old truck, I have
Well, you guys aren't going to use this every day, are you?
No. Well, for local stuff, we can tow with it. But, like, out of town, no. Absolutely.
Oh, so you're not going to take this, like, to Riverside or nothing?
No. I mean, it can if we're in a pinch and we need to, but we're going to try not to. I love this remote.
How many Smashbox does truck come with?
It's coming. It has four right now, and they're shipping us two more. So we're gonna keep two on the cables. Yeah, I got them to throw me in two more. They're the light ones too. They weigh 29 pounds.
Does this have a side pull?
No, no side pull. It's a rotator.
It's a rotator. Yeah. You really don't need one.
Right. I mean, there's times where I'm sure it'd be nice if you're in a tight spot.
Yeah, but with the rotator, you should be able to take, like, if you got to upright a trailer, mm-hmm. or even if you. Got a whole trailer?
Mm-hmm.
Did it come with those big straps?
Like the what kind?
Like the big ones.
Big yellow straps?
Yeah.
No, it didn't come with any of those, but it came with like the endless loops, the blue, red, yellow. But we have some from the 50 tons.
We need to throw one of those big recovery straps in this truck because this is where we're going to use it.
Yep. Seem like
good.
Sure does take a while to put it all away when you're all boomed out. You got a cable in, and boom down. Look at all these functions I'm going right now.
They all work simultaneously?
Yeah, and it's like as if you're sitting at the control station. The harder you push it, the faster it goes.
This truck has like 20 gearings on it.
I know, it's awesome.
Is your dad like cleaning his chains off?
Yeah.
I didn't clean mine, I just threw them in there.
Bad. Yours were fine in the front. Those got all over the grease.
They're gonna get dirty.
They're gonna get dirty, but you know.
Try to keep them clean as long as we can.
Yeah.
Don't forget to give me those smaller forks for the 12 pound record.
They're sitting right in that bay. And there's U-bolt forks in there too that we won't need, so you might as well throw them in there.
I'm trying to do bigger things with the 12 pound. I'm up to frame fork in the Frontier trucks.
Uh huh. Nice.
I'm still having a little bit of a hard time chaining them down. I wonder if we got those stick ratchet straps like I used to do with the U-Hauls instead of chaining the front axle, we can strap it. Because most of the time the chain.
I would say with the 12 ton, it wouldn't be a bad idea to put straps in there. For my stuff, like for the heavy, I like chains. I know people use straps, but I like chains. I want to clean these hooks off. Most part. Dale, you mind putting these up on the hook up there? That D-ring right here.
Which one? This one?
Yeah. No, right here. Yeah. I'll rotate. Coming up. Special. That side, you got yours?
Yeah.
That's probably the best way to do it if you got two people.
Yeah.
Run both sides together really quick. pretty capable. Pretty awesome.
That's cool.
Where are you keeping the step stool? Thank you for watching. As always, like, comment, subscribe. Hopefully you did enjoy that video.